when it's talking about the, you know, the mysteries. And actually, it was Tychicus that, Tychicus or whatever, was carrying the letter that was written by Paul. And I knew that when I did the mistake, it was going to be caught. I knew that, people would jump all over that. Oh, no, see, he's wrong. See, Paul wrote that letter. It wasn't Tychicus. He just carried the message. I knew that people would kind of stammer at that. And the reason why I did it is because, well, these are the same people who can't even tell what's going on in their own country. They can't even tell what's going on, who the hands and finger of the whore, the harlot is. You know, they're people, they're ministers of light who walk in light, but yet they couldn't tell you who's destroying their nation. They couldn't tell you that. But yet we take everything in the, see, I didn't go to cemetery. I didn't take the oath of office. I didn't take the oath of office that you sit there and say, I swear to uphold and promise to protect all idolaters and people who would destroy my country and my nation under the guise of Christianity and pretend that they are Christians too. I will protect and defend and honor them. You know? Oh, but they're for pro-life. Traitors. The Bible says in the last days, traitors, traitors, traitors. Traitors against the kingdom of God. Traitors against the works of God. Traitors, traitors. You know, God's leaving behind all things that offend. Oh, but I'm a born-again Christian. I'm going to go up into heaven. I'm going to be born again. I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. Really? Well, my Holy Ghost is telling me one thing, and your Holy Ghost is telling you another thing. Yours is saying that they're not, there's nothing wrong with them. That they're brothers in Christ too. And it's a good thing that they're all in political power just like they were in Nazi Germany. So one of us is walking in light and one of us is lying about it. And so we come to this crop circle. About seeing the eyes. Can you see what's going on? Can you see what God is trying to do here? Yes, he made America the most powerful nation on earth. Why? Because he knew that the dragon would take it from us. Like he destroyed Germany. Because they had the press, they printed up Bibles, and they sent the gospel message out. Now do you think that your neighbors with their idolatry are Christians too? Look at your country. Look what's happening. You think John Kerry cares about you? Do you think he cares? He's being manipulated and motivated by what he thinks is the voice of God. And it's not the voice of God at all. FYI, he was also a Skull and Bones member who was running up against George Bush in George Bush's second term. And what did I tell you about the picture? The picture that the Yale University students did, they were going to make sure that George Bush was the last president before Rome had put in and instilled their Antichrist. You see? They were going to make sure of that. But John Kerry is still listening to the big banking industries. He's still listening to the big money people. That's the God. That's the God of this world. The ones with all the wealth, right? But I want you to also know that the Skull and Bones people also had a man by the name of Henry Stimson, who wasn't Secretary of War during the Truman administration. He was a defunct Secretary of War. He had his term was up, but he still had enough influence to get Truman to drop the bomb on Nagasaki, Hiroshima. He was a Skull and Bones member. Death, the order of death. We're facing World War III here. I mean, he's ready to go head-to-head with Putin. And Putin's the only one who really knows what's really happening. He told his people over there, don't go banking with the Rothschilds. The Vatican bankers who have taken the money of the world and brought us into war and sent our children to fight in battles so that they can build weaponry, so that they can make profit for their stockholders. $700 billion. Who had that kind of money to put a political figure in the White House? Nobody saw it. Nobody noticed that a false messiah. Nobody from the pulpit noticed it. The debates take place at Saddleback. John McCain mentions the figure $700 billion were funding terrorism because in the purchase of oil. We need to start to dig for oil now. 33 days later, that same amount is missing from the coffers of America. out of the housing market, which is interesting because they took, you know, because I don't think God could have set this up any more obvious for us to see, out of the housing market to buy one house. All those people lost their homes, bank foreclosures, out in the street so that one man could have one house. Who had $700 billion? Who said no to the hot potato of the paper that was going around? Didn't want to buy the notes. Instead wanted to take the money and buy one house. They thought they were being clever, and that's what gave up the enemy, and that's why the enemy is going to turn on the ecclesiastical Rome and, you know, pay her back double. Pay her back double, the Bible says. Pay her back double. It's wrath. The enemy is angry when his hands and fingers give him up. They gave him up. Look at this nation, the most powerful nation on earth, and who's attracted to power but evil forces? And look at how many people in political office today are Roman Catholic. Just like in Nazi Germany. I think God's trying to tell us something, but yet not a minister in the pulpit could realize. They named his car the Beast. Muslim name, Obamanation. I mean, you know, how much more did God have to do? I mean, except for the neon sign over his head saying, this is the one who I warned you about. So who am I in the picture? Well, I'm the master's bait. To pull away and draw away this power from him, right? I'm not into politics. I don't have any money, and you know what money I have, I, you know, tied to my church, and I, you know, try to pay my rent. I'm just a regular blue collar worker like everyone else. I drive a truck. I work for Land Air Express, and that's a funny thing, because when God pulls me up out of the earth, you'll know what hour you're in. And the enemy doesn't win, does he, if we do this right? But where are the men of God who aren't traitors? I want people who don't want to betray the gospel of Jesus Christ, who go around calling the whore and the harlot one of us. She's not. She never has been. All she's ever done is wanted to destroy nation after nation because, well, the Bible interferes with what she believes. But if you're a parochial school student in a Protestant church, you know, as a associate minister, you know, well, you went through the fires. You have no, you know, idols don't bother you. Calling men father doesn't trouble you. The things that Jesus warned you about. You know, your discernment is that you can't discern. You go and say that the Old Testament's just a history book and everything, all the prophecy's been fulfilled because you're educated by the powers of darkness around you. So you don't discern light because, well, your darkness doesn't like the light. And so what little darkness that's in you doesn't want to discern that it's dark. Because like people who are caught up in cult groups that are in darkness, they don't want to admit that they can be deceived. They don't want to believe that they can be fooled like that. They don't want to believe that they're buying, quackery, you know, that they're falling for the for something moronic, because to look at themselves and realize that they've done this thing, well, it's such a humbling episode, you know, getting to realize that you were deceived. And no one likes to believe that they've been deceived because they want to believe that they're smarter than that, because I'm a better person than that, because of what, you know, and the Bible says to humble yourself. Well, you're probably saying, you know, I should look in the mirror. Look, I wouldn't ask you to go through the childhood that I went through. I wouldn't. I wouldn't ask you to take the call that I'm taking here. You know, but I've got 7 billion souls that I need to get to the foot of the cross before resurrection. So don't think that, you know, that this is an easy thing for me. It's not. But I want you to know that you might, if you've been deceived, then admit that you've been deceived and get right with God. You know, let some light shine on that darkness. See the fact that these people are not Christians. Come on. You know, this isn't hard to figure out. This isn't hard. This is all about bringing people to the truth of freedom, of knowing that this is where free will goes when it's not in right relationship with its creator. And don't see the truth. You rob God of his glory. You're a traitor. Is it your fault? Say you walk in the light, you have the Holy Spirit in you, but you can't see what God's doing. It doesn't sound like to me you're on our side. Scary. It's scary, isn't it? When you think that you're sitting there under this man of God who's trying to watch and protect your soul, you know, you're the sheep and he's the shepherd, and the shepherd can't see. It tells you something, doesn't it? When the shepherd can't see, it must say something to you. Where am I being led? Where are you taking me here? You had me go out and vote for a man who said he would be God someday, that his religion is false, it's demonic, it's started up by an angel of light. The Bible says if we or another person preached, an angel of light preached to you another gospel than the one we heard, let him be accursed. You couldn't wait to try and make him president so that all the little children can sit there with their hands on their hearts and say, one nation under God, while the devil rolled on the floor and laughed. If you don't know what this battle is about, if you don't understand what this battle is, see, this is not about Hollywood. See, Hollywood does the battle a little differently. They give demons powers that they don't really have. They give the devil, you know, power that he really doesn't have. Everything he has is just basically built upon lie and lie and lie. You know, say this prayer, pray to this saint, go to this priest, do this thing, you know, you must become a nun, you know. Then you got to serve God, you got to either be a nun or a priest. No, you don't. To serve God, all you got to do is call upon his name and ask him, what can I do for you, Lord, after all that you've done for me? Christ did it all, finished it completely on the cross. It was done. No purgatories. No coming and doing religious acts of garbage, because when Jesus said on the cross, it was finished, it was finished. And all he wanted you to do was to see what happens to sin. That God must judge sin. And he was the sin offering. He was the judgment. God's judgment, wrath poured out on his son. That was meant for me. And it was me who put Christ on that cross because of my sin. But some people just don't. I'm not satisfied with this crucifixion. They got to keep crucifying him over and over and over again. They got to keep doing a religious thing because they don't accept the fact that Jesus' work was sufficient for the salvation of all the world, that they have to have a hand in it too. We need to do this too. We need to help Jesus. No, Jesus don't need any help, to be honest with you. Jesus don't need any help. You know, he just wants obedience. He just wants people to obey, honor his teachings, honor his commands, honor his word. And when you see the truth, stand on it. When you see the fact that, yeah, his effigy is sitting out there in Egypt. Gee, we didn't even notice that before. Is that why you can solve all the puzzles? Yes, that's why I solve all the puzzles. Creature robbed me of a childhood times two. Family. But God in his mercy, God in his love, God in his compassion, said he would restore what the enemy took away from me, what the cankerworm had taken from me. So I have what he needs. Not only do I have his peace plan, but I have his body. And that is the glory of my God. And that's what this is really all about. This is all about setting people free and showing them the truth. That evil does exist. And God dressed his creature. His creature has hands and fingers. And if you don't think hell is real, you just ask the kids that are living in lands that there's war zones going on. You don't think hell is real. Because that's the devil bringing it up here on earth. You want to know if hell is real, you just go live in one of those communities. You go and live where there's violence everywhere. And you don't tell me that hell is real. This isn't hell, because this is not where you will spend eternity. But God's given you an offer, an opportunity